Frostbite Theater presents Cold Cuts, No Baloney.
Just science.
It's called an accelerator because we're trying to speed something up. It's called an electron accelerator. So what are we speeding up?
Electrons.
Yeah, in a machine we grab electrons. We rip them off of atoms, which is not that hard to do. Shove them in the accelerator. The accelerator is a machine shaped like a racetrack, about a mile around. Only job, take electrons, speed them up. We take the electrons, we speed them up to about the speed of light, which is 186,000 miles a second. If you could run at the speed of light, you could run around the Earth 7.5 times in a second. So speed of light's moving really fast. And then to study atoms, what you do, take the lump of the junk you want to study, take these electrons moving at about the speed of light, and you smack them into each other. Okay, pretend you're an atom. Okay, you're sitting there, you're talking to atom friends, mind your own atom business, and some scientist comes along and throws an electron at your head, moving at about the speed of light. What's your head going to do?
Explode.
Yeah, your head's going to pop off. Right? It's going to go flying across the room, splatter against the wall, be kind of gross. What's the electron going to do?
Stop.
It's going to hit my head and then
stop.
Bounce somewhere, right? It's going to go somewhere else. So maybe instead of going directly behind me, maybe the electron bounces that way while my head flies off that way. Okay, that's how we study atoms here. We throw things at them. And then we look to see where the bits and pieces go. And by saying where the bits and pieces go, we can figure out how it's put together. Now, our machine that does this for us, our accelerator, only works because opposite charges attract and like charges repel, right? We use electrons. What do electrons have that are different than, say, protons or neutrons? What charge do they have? They're negative, right? And since they have a charge, we can push them around. So if you have an electron sitting here that's positive, or that's negative, and you want to go that way, what can I put in front of it? I put a positive charge in front of it, because what do opposite charges do? They attract. Or what can I put behind it? Another negative, because what do same charges do? They repel, right? And that's what our accelerator does. We arrange it so that the electrons passing through that we're trying to push always see a negative charge in back of them and a positive charge in front of them. So they get pushed through a machine and sped up. And again, it works because our machine gets the timing right. And it works because opposite charges attract and like charges repel. Who in here believes that opposite charges attract and like charges repel? Like three people. Who must see it or you refuse to believe it? Okay, I can get behind that. That's more like science. I can try to show you with this. What is this?
I have
no idea. Not a piece of tape. Not a piece of plastic. This is a very expensive piece of scientific equipment. It's called an electroscope, and it's made from a little clippy thing, and not a piece of plastic. It's made from two pieces of plastic. I know. We have spared no expense for your education, right? Two pieces of plastic. So what I can do, I can take my finger, and I can scrape it on the plastic sheets. Electrons will get ripped off of me. They'll pile onto the plastic. If one piece of plastic gets extra electrons on it, what charge will it have?
Negative.
If the other piece of plastic also gets extra electrons, what charge will it have?
Negative.
If I get negative next to negative, what do? They repel, right? Like that. Okay, so negative here, same charges, they try to spread apart. In my pocket, I have a pen. If I put the pen between the plastic sheets, what will happen? Actually, nothing. All right, kind of a boring experiment. Over here, I have a nail. I put the nail between the plastic sheets, what'll happen?
We don't know.
Yeah, now it jumps to it. Yeah. So how come it jumps to the nail but not the pen? Nail is metal, pen is? Plastics make good insulators. Right, for electricity, that means the electrons in the pen can't move around all that well. So if I have extra electrons in the plastic sheet, I shove the pen in there. The extra electrons are pushing on the electrons in the pen. Electrons in the pen are trying to get away, but they can't move. It's an insulator, so they're stuck, so nothing really happens. The nail, though, made from, which is a good conductor, that means the electrons can move around. So if I have extra electrons in the plastic sheet, I shove the nail in there. The extra electrons push on the electrons in the nail. Electrons in the nail want to get away, and since they can move, they do. They back off. What stays behind? What can't move in the nail? Yeah, the atom. Right? The atoms are stuck. So if you're an atom, you're stuck, and one of your electrons runs off screaming to the night in that direction, what charge do you get? Positive. Right. If I lose a negative, I become a positive. So the negatives back off. This becomes positive. This is negative. Those are opposite charges, and opposite charges attract. Right. How about me? Am I a conductor or an insulator? How can I test? Put my finger in there. Yeah. If I put my finger in there, if I'm an insulator, what'll happen? Yeah, nothing. If I'm a conductor, what'll happen? It'll jump to me. Yeah. Yeah, I'm a conductor. I'm not a great conductor, but I'm a good enough conductor. Electricity will flow through me. What happens if a lot of electricity flows through me? I die. What do they call that? Yeah, it's called electrocution. One group said funny. It's not called funny. It's called electrocution. And the reason why I'm slightly worried about electrocution is we're going to play with this thing. This is called a Van de Graaff generator, named after Mr. Van de Graaff. And it's basically a person walking across a carpet machine. How many of you have ever walked across the carpet and then you touch the doorknob or your kid's sister or something like that, and there was a spark? Why does it do that? Yeah, if I walk across the rug, what can I grab off the rug? I can grab electrons off the rug, and they pile up on me. And it's nothing personal. If I get a lot of extra charge on me, it's going to try to spread out, go somewhere else where there's more room. And if my kid's sister happens to be sitting there, you know, maybe I can give her some of the electrons. I'm just sharing. I'm not trying to shock or anything. And that is kind of what this thing does. There's a motor inside of here, and when I turn it on, it makes this belt go around and around and around, and that's like a person walking on the carpet. It's going to dump electrons onto this dome. If this dome gets one extra electron on it, does it care? No, it's just one, so what? What if I get two, side by side? What will they do? Negative next to negative. They're going to repel. Right? They're going to get as far apart as they possibly can. I don't know where exactly they'll go, but they'll spread out as best they can. What if I get three? They're going to spread out as best they can. What if I get like a billion? Sooner or later, what's going to happen? Sooner or later, I'm going to get too many charges, too small a space. They want to spread out to the largest thing around. What's the largest thing around? No, not me. I'm not the largest thing around. Big round thing. The Earth. The planet. It wants to get into the Earth. I'm not larger than the planet. Thank you very much. Right? It wants to get into the Earth in part because there's a lot of room, plenty of space to spread out, and partly because that's where these electrons are coming from in the first place. When we do this, we're not making new electrons. We're just moving them from one place to the other. So what we're basically doing is reaching into the Earth, grabbing some electrons, and then plopping them up here. And then for everything to balance out again, that same number of electrons needs to get down to the Earth. So to help them get there, we have a second dome, connects with the wire, and if you were to trace it, it comes out of the plug here. This part of the plug, which is called the ground. Why is that called the ground?
Because
it goes to the ground. Right. If you were to trace this through the building, you would find out that it literally goes into the Earth. So this gives the electricity a nice way to get into the planet instead of through some other conductors standing nearby, such as?
You.
Me. Yeah, I'm on the ground. I conduct. It could try to go through me together. That could be bad. So we give it an easier way, and hopefully it picks the easier way and not the way that it ends up going through me. So what will it look like if charges are able to jump from one dome to the other? Like, what's the electricity look like? Like lightning? Okay. Let's find out. Three. Two, one. Now the first one I hear is like a little crackly sound. Ooh, a little crackly sound. Then we're gonna sneak up on it with the other dome. Tell you what, we can see it better if you don't freak out and if we turn the lights off. What's it look like? Little bit like baby lightning, and it's making little baby thunder. Lights back on, please. Why is it making little baby thunder? How does lightning make thunder? The lightning jumps through the air, and then it heats up the air. This little spark is actually hotter than the surface of the sun. So it jumps through the air, it heats up the air expands, and then it bumps in the neighboring air. And then that makes a shockwave that we hear. But how come in a thunderstorm, you see the lightning, and then you hear it, but right now we see it and hear it at the same time? Yeah, light's faster than sound. In the room, the light still gets to you first. But the gap in time between the light reaching you and the sound reaching you, it's just too small to notice that there's a gap. If you were to back up, sooner or later you get far enough away that you would begin to notice, ooh, now I see it, and now, ooh, I hear it. So in a real thunderstorm, lightning strikes, 5 seconds go by, then you hear it, how far away?
1 mile.
Yeah, about 1 mile. Takes sound about 5 seconds to travel 1 mile. So that's a pretty close strike. You'll also notice when the domes are far, sparks are big, but the gap in time between each spark is also kind of big. If I get them close together, smaller sparks, but they happen sooner. Why does it take less time to spark when they're close, but more when they're further apart? Further apart, what's there more up between the domes? Not space, we'd all be dead. Air. Yeah, air is a pretty good insulator. And when there's a lot of insulation between the domes, hard jump to make. I need to get a lot of extra electrons where they can jump across that big gap. So it takes me longer to get the right number. If I get them close together, not as much of a gap, easier jump to make. I don't need as many electrons, so I get the right number sooner, so the sparks can happen faster. What would happen if the domes were to touch? It would explode? Should we try it? That went south really quick. So now let's... Nothing. Why does nothing happen? How much insulation?
None.
There's no insulation. Nothing stops the electrons from going from here to here, so they don't stop. They get on this dome, they walk to the other dome, go through the wire and into the ground. As soon as I pull them apart, then there's a gap they need to bridge. So they need to build up until enough of them to jump across the other one. So let's try a couple of things. What's this? Not marshmallows. Yeah, little bits of styrofoam. Little bits of styrofoam in a bowl, which is nice, but weirdly, the bowl has a suction cup on the bottom, which is weird. But it's nice for us, because we can take the bowl and stick it to the dome thusly. And then we'll turn it on. What's going to happen? Why are they going to fly away?
Because static electricity.
Trace this out for me. Turn this on, what gets on here? Electrons. If I get electrons next to electrons, what do they try to do? Try to spread out. So some of them spread out to the bowl. Some get in the bowl, some get on this, some get on this. If this little piece of foam has extra electrons on it, what charge will it have? If this has extra electrons, what charge will it have? Get negative next to negative, what do they do? They repel. If the whole dome is negative, what do they do to it? Repel from that too. Let's find out. 3, 2, 1. Fly, be free, go. Not too bad. Let's try something else. What is this? It's strain. It's like fake hair. It's like really bad weave. And it's on a suction cup, which again is weird, but it's nice for us because I can stick it on here thusly. And then we'll turn it on. What's going to happen? Why? Yeah, I mean, same reason that we have for the phone, right? I'm going to get charge on here. It's going to try to spread out. It's going to get on the strain. All the strains become negative. They're going to repel each other. But unlike the foam, they're tied down. So they can't fly around the room and make a big mess on the floor. 3, 2, 1. Not too bad. Now, what will the fake hairs do if I get the grounding dome close to them?
They'll just fall.
They attract to it. Why are they attract to it?
Because they have a lot of electrons. Yeah.
If those are negative, they attract to this, then what's this?
Positive.
How this get to be positive?
Because it is.
Right, sitting here minding its own business. Why is it positive?
Proton.
If you're an electron over here, what do you see over there? I see a bunch of negative. If there's a bunch of negative over there, and I'm an electron over here that's negative, what do I want to do? I want to get away from that thing. Can I get away from that thing? Yeah. Where do I go?
Ground.
Through the wire and...
Ground.
into the ground, what stays behind? Yeah, the atoms. This is just like the nail, right? The atoms are stuck, the electrons back off, so this becomes positive. This is positive, that's negative, they're opposite charges, and opposite charges attract. What if the domes touch?
They'll just fall.
What will the strains do?
They'll fall.
They'll fall, yeah, because there's no charge in the dome. Take it away, goes back up. Let them touch, go back down. Want to do jumping jacks? Make it do jumping jacks, kind of like that. Now, what would happen if a person were to touch it?
They get electrocuted.
Or maybe a better question is, should a person touch it?
Yes.
Well, maybe yes, maybe no. Let's think this through for a bit. Do you know...